Dear students, let us discuss about design of commutator and brushes. Already in previous semester in machine subject, you have studied about function of commutator as well as brushes. Okay. The function of commutator is to rectify the alternating current induced in the armature conductors. It is cylindrical in shape and is placed at one end of the armature. Okay. Here commutator will be placed at one end of the armature, right? And its function is to rectify the alternating current induced in the armature conductors. Okay. Next we'll discuss under design of commutator how number of segments are commutator segments are decided. Okay. The number of commutator segment is equal to number of coils. And this is given mathematically as C equal to half US, where C is number of coils, U number of coil sides per slot, and S is number of slots. Okay. Then minimum number of segment is that which gives a voltage of 15 volt between segments at no load. See, while deciding number of segments, commutator segments between two segments at no load condition, voltage must be less than 15 volt. Therefore, minimum number of commutator segment is taken as EP divided by 15, where E is generated EMF and P is number of poles. Okay. So this image shows how commutator is built. Usually, between two commutator segment, mica is used as insulation material, and this is armature, and commutator will be fixed at one end of the armature, and these are the brushes to supply current to the external circuit. Current is collected from rotating part of this commutator via brushes. Okay. Then how commutator diameter is decided? Under design of commutator, you should know how diameter as well as length of commutator is decided. And here usually diameter of commutator is generally between 0.6 to 0.8 of armature diameter. If diameter of armature is say D, then diameter of commutator will be 0.6 D to 0.8 D. See in this image, if diameter of armature is say D, then diameter of this commutator will be 0.6 to 0.8 D. Again, it depends upon voltage ratings, percentage of that diameter, commutator diameter in terms of armature diameter will change. See, it varies from 62% of armature diameter for 350 to 700 volt machines, 68% for 200 to 500 volt machines, and 75% for 100 to 125 volt machine. Okay. And usually machines can be designed for high voltage, low current applications depending upon type of winding. Right, the machine which is designed for high voltage, high current, low voltage applications, diameter of commutator may be more than 0.6 to 0.8 of armature diameter. Okay, then this is also very important factor to be considered while deciding diameter of armature, because peripheral speed of armature sometimes taken as limiting factor. Okay, the peripheral voltage gradient around the commutator should be limited to about 3 volt per mm in order to avoid ionization of skin of air at the commutator surface. Okay, thus for 600 volt machine, minimum peripheral distance between adjacent brush arms should be, it is given as 600 volt and 3 volt per mm as peripheral voltage gradient. Therefore, gap between two adjacent brush can be 200 mm. Okay, the diameter must be chosen with regard to one peripheral speed, another is thickness of commutator segment. These two are taken as deciding factor. One is peripheral speed, another is thickness of commutator segment or commutator pitch, right? Then what should be the peripheral speed for armature based on deciding diameter of commutator? the commutator peripheral speed is generally kept below 15 meter per second. Higher speeds, peripheral speed up to 30 meters can be used in some special cases. Okay, and if higher commutator peripheral speeds are chosen, then there is problem of commutation difficulties because reversal of current should take place within given commutation time. Okay, then another factor is commutator segment pitch. The thickness of commutator segment at the commutator surface should not be less than 3 mm. Okay, if the thickness of mica is about 0.8 mm, then the minimum segment pitch is approximately 4 mm between two commutator segment. Mica is used as insulation material and its thickness should not be less than 0.8 mm. Okay, see here, these are commutator segments and this is mica. Okay, so all armature coils will be connected to commutator segments via risers, right? Then how to decide length of commutator? The length of commutator depends upon two factors. One is space required by the brushes and another is surface required to dissipate the heat generated by the commutator losses. Okay, these two factors will decide length of commutator. One is space required for the brushes because brushes are fixed on the commutator. Okay, and whatever space required for commutator and dimensions of brush again depends upon rating of the machine. And second is to dissipate heat properly during whatever conversion of energy is there, that commutation losses needs sufficient area to dissipate heat generated. Okay, so here symbolically this figure shows what is minimum thickness is required or width and length that will decide area of brush. Then how dimensions of brushes are decided? The thickness of brush has profound influence on commutation conditions, right? And as per this from this figure you will understand the thickness of brush and commutator segment pitch are factors which determine width of the commutating zone as well as number of coils undergoing commutation at a time. Okay, and the thickness of brush should be so selected that it should cover 2 to 3 commutator segment. When that thickness of brush whatever decided, this thickness of brush will usually cover 2 to 3 commutator segments on the outer surface of commutator. Okay, then current carried by each brush spindle is 2 IA/P because each spindle can have so many brushes. Okay, then total brush contact area per spindle is given as AP equal to 2 IA/P into del A, where del A is current density in brushes, and the current density in the brushes can be taken depending upon type of brush. Basically, in case of DC machine, 4 types of brushes are used. One is natural graphite, then hard carbon, electro graphite, metal graphite, depending upon type of machine. See, electro graphite brushes are widely used in industrial machines. Okay, they have low rate of wear and therefore they are extensively used in traction application. And if you say use of metal graphite, advantages of metal graphite brushes are they have low contact voltage drop. They can use for high value of current densities. Okay, therefore the metal graphite brushes are suitable for low voltage high current machines. Then what are low voltage high current machines? Generally motors which are used for battery vehicles as well as for automobile starters, they need brushes of this kind, metal graphite. Okay, then area of each individual brush should be taken so that it doesn't carry more than, say this is current handling capacity of each brush, should not exceed 70 amps, and it is better to use large number of brushes of relatively smaller width than a few very wide brushes. Number of brushes may be increased depending upon number of coils. Okay, see here we will discuss how area of brushes is decided. Suppose if NB is number of brushes per spindle and WB and TB are respectively the width and thickness of each brush respectively, then contact area of each brush, area is width into thickness, AB equal to area of each brush, AB equal to WB into TB. Total contact area of brush in one spindle AB equal to, what is NB? NB is number of brushes per fendal, number of brushes into area of each brush. That will give, as AB is W into TB, therefore A, this small AB, that is contact area of each brush, then total contact area of brush in one spindle AB equal to NB W into TB. Therefore, width of each brush, from this equation, width of each brush is WB, which is equal to AB divided by NB into TB. This is equal to, then what is AB? So here, you know AB is 2IA divided by P into del A. So 2IA by P into del A divided by NB into TB. This will give width of each brush. Okay. Then how length of commutator is decided? Length of commutator LC is given by NB into WB plus CB plus C1 plus C2. Okay. Where CB is clearance between the brushes, and it depends upon the construction of brush holder, and usually it is 5 mm. Okay. C1 is the clearance allowed for straggling the brushes, and this clearance varies with the size of commutator, but generally it lies between 10 mm for machines to about 30 mm for large machines. Okay. This clearance may vary between 10 mm to 30 mm depending upon rating of machine, and C2 is clearance for allowing the end play, and usually this clearance is between 10 to 25 mm. Okay. Then from this equation, so this equation gives minimum length of commutator required, minimum length of commutator as well length required for the brushes. If this length gives too small a dissipating surface so that the temperature rise of commutator exceeds the permissible value, then LC must be increased to give sufficient surface to dissipate the heat generated by the commutator losses. Okay. See, here you have seen, while deciding dimensions in terms of length of the commutator, the length of commutator depends upon two factors. One is space required by brushes, and second is surface required to dissipate heat generated by the commutator losses. See, we have discussed what is surface area or space required by the brushes. It depends upon its width in terms of thickness as well as other dimensions, that and taking current density as well as area into consideration, size of brush can be decided, and depending upon size of brush, length of commutator will change, right? So this is about design of commutator in terms of its diameter as well as length, and how area of brush is decided as well as its width of each brush is decided, right?